last field again, cutting our barley. We've got that chunk there to cut out. Hopefully the weather is going to hold today and we can get this field finished. It is going to be late into the evening, so whether we will get anything baled before the rain comes, we don't know. The next job we need to do will be the potato harvest after that. You can do that while on a wet crop icon. But, yeah, we've got this field to do, the field of potatoes, the field of sugar beet, and then we want to get some drilling done before the winter, so our crops are ready a little earlier next year. Got a funny shaped piece here with rows longer and shorter, so we're taking this piece out to even it up. Taking out the next split. The combine has worked faultlessly. And, already 25% pulls. Good yield this field. It's yielding pretty well, so had 4 trailers off this field so far, so good bit of money to come back in from this. Tonight's live stream may well be a lone oak palm, but, we've had a request to do Lone Oak Farm from one of our subscribers, Farmer Austin, who is also doing a live stream series on that. So live stream one will be tonight. We are going to be using seasons, and everything that's done will be done on a live stream. We won't be doing any videos. Is just going to be a Thursday live stream. Every Thursday will be Lone Oak Farm for the time be foreseeable future, unless viewing figures are so low that it's not worth doing it. But there are a lot of people out there doing Lone Oak Farm. Actually seen anyone else doing Millhouse Farm. I'd imagine there are a good few people who are doing it. But, the series is coming in well. This is going to be the last breed down here, I think. We may miss little bits here, there and everywhere. Hopefully we can get through without leaving any crop. With Lone Oak Farm, we are going to start off with what equipment it gives us and work our way up to equipment we need. Save a lot of messing about, setting up with new equipment and cheating money into it. But, it's almost a full tank on just one round in here, so I'm not even going to get all the way round, I don't think. Don't even get to the end. Hopefully we can get to this trailer and then we can... Just missed a little touch there. We've got to really be concentrating here. It's a little bit wider were trying to concentrate on that and we missed the part where the grain tank got full. There's not enough left there to worry about. We're not going to run about fetching little chunks like that back. Combine has done almost 15 hectares of crop so far. There is our combine now emptying into the trailer. Let's go nudge back a bit. Let's get that piece, that's lovely. This one breed left down there, and then there's that chunk there to fetch out, so that was a very high yielding part. Now it'll go again. We can now try to get all of this in. Not sure whether we will. No, we're not going to. It's a little wider this end. We will fetch this end back. Is a little wider this end than it was the other end. Longer strip, we don't, if it's just one little clump then we wouldn't have bothered, but being a fairly long strip it's worth going and fetching. Not that we're getting much barley off it. Cheap to have left it there to rot away. Probably cost more in diesel than we actually got for it. Let's begin here now. And this one here now we shall pull round. Out in two breeds. The Monday and Tuesday streams, they will alternate between Churn Farm, Hopefield Farm and here. Live stream one will be tonight. It will be run with seasons, as all of our maps do, because I can't get into the game properly without seasons now that it's here. Almost 16 hectares harvested. That's little chunks like that. Don't go back for, it's not really worth the effort of going back. Just one little chunk, already almost half full in the combine. Wants a good wash down as well once harvest is finished, before it's put back in the shed. And, well here now. We should get this a bit wider there, but just swing out a little. We should get this field done today. And tomorrow's in-game day will, as long as the rain holds off a little, do a bit of baling in this field. Lost a lot of the straw we was going to bale up. We've got one trailer load down at the cow yard because we're hoping to get cows next season. See when we sell our crops how much money we get. 75% full already, so we are really in a bumpy yield here. That's 80%. Turn around, get the auger out. Shorter and shorter, so there is not a great lump of harvest left to do here. The potato field was almost finished ploughing the other day. So this is really yielding well. We've got nowhere near a full header of corn there. So this end of the field yielding well. As you can see, the trailer is 60% full already. We should trample this bit of barley here. Get drilling, we will have a video of drilling. And as long as we get in the oilseed rape and the wheat before winter sets in, then the barley and the soybeans can be drilled next spring. Empty out our tank. This trailer should be almost full by the time we've emptied, if it isn't full. May well fill the trailer even. Two of the Larrington trailers. Quite fill it, so we'll have a buy another couple of fields, I'm going to need a bigger combine. The trouble is with that is getting around the farm tracks and through the gateways. Let's choose our equipment pretty wisely. You saw the earlier videos, we was getting stuck with the trailers. We had some bigger bale trailers to what we've got now. We was getting stuck in the gateways with it. It was too big to get in, so that is the one consideration when purchasing a new combine. This combine may well manage another season. John Deere 1550, you can't see what it is now, it's getting that dusty now, it's very dusty combine. Hopefully it won't catch fire before we finish this season's harvest, washed at the yard. It's really bulking out this barley, the grain tank filling rather quickly, 20% full already and not gone far at all. Go in the cab for a short while and see, it's now 25% full. Field now. Maybe you can get some baling done, maybe not on screen, but some baling done in this game day. So if we do get rain overnight, we should at least get some bales out of here. Start full again. And these are only short rows, remember, so one round and a little bit of thin strip, and we have almost half a tank of core barley. Very happy with this yield. That's half full now. The other side there before it fills up, we've got, no we won't, we've got one more round here to do, so we may well get the tank full over this side, is now coming to right where the 67% full already. Spin around, one more breed down here, then probably take this end out and come back to that piece to our left. Sorry I can't talk right now. You send three sorry I can't talk right now messages and they still keep ringing. Set in, we will have to but we shall start putting the auger out as we go down. It'll give us much time once we get set in to finish this off. 7 minutes of the video time to go, I think. Off this field, so pretty good yield. Probably going to get to this end of the field as well. So now to go back, let's get set in. Tractor, it's a long run this time. We've got 5 minutes recording time left to go. Hopefully we will get a bit more of this harvest done in that 5 minutes. Now I think it's going to take up all of our time to 10% of this trailer left to put in, so we'll have to swap the tractors around once we get set in. Considering how wet this autumn has been, apart from losing an old heap of straw, we have done pretty well to get the harvest done. Looks like we've got the first day of winter, it's going to rain, so maybe we may just be able to work a bit of the land or something during first part of the autumn, the winter, sorry. Button I press to do that, it now and again it does it, and there we are, we've got that in there. That tractor is coming forward a little. Combine will now empty out. Back so we can see that a little. Two minutes left of the video, so we'll see how much we can get done before we say goodbye to you. There we go. The auger goes in. To the end of the video, so all that's left to say is I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please give it a like, give it a share. If you are new to Summer Farm Estates and you want to see more content from us, subscribe to the channel, hit the bell notification icon, which will let you know when these videos are uploaded to YouTube, when we do our live streams. Until next time, all that's left to say is thank you for watching and bye bye.